What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I hope that you guys are doing absolutely amazing, beautiful, and groovy on today. And as promised, I told you guys via Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram that I would be doing a Q&A with Mika Joi video on today, which is March 7th. And so here I am to answer a few questions that have been posted. Before we go any further, though, if you guys are not sipping with me, I invite you to go ahead and join me. Today, I decided, as you can tell, not to do any tea. On this fabulous Friday, I felt like fixing me a glass of pink Moscato. So that's what your girl is sipping on today. And so, I hope that you guys choose your favorite beverage and join me in sipping while watching this video. And I'm going to get moving because I'm going to try to get this video done as quickly as possible. So, first question, which was asked by a gentleman who follows me on Instagram as well as Twitter. Well, we follow each other. His name is Dr. Pops. And his question was, what does romance mean to you today? Dr. Pops, if you're watching, how you doing, sir? And let me just tell you that this question had your girl stuck. I really had to think long and hard, what does romance mean to me? Because I think I really didn't realize it anymore. I felt like I didn't know. And so I really don't know why I didn't expect this type of question from him, guys, because he has a blog, which is a single black male, where he talks about relationships. He talks about different topics, you know, centered around being a male and, you know, being out there in the dating world. And so be sure to put his information below in the description box so that you guys can go on and check out his blog. But I'm gonna try to answer this question to the best of my ability. What romance means to me today is, I feel that romance is that type of feeling that is that intoxicating type feeling in a good way. You know what I'm saying? It's a feeling that makes you feel so good on the inside that it shows on the outside when you have that romance between you and another person. It's a drunken love type feeling. It's the type of feeling that when someone looks at you, they see romance. They see that, they can visually see that on the outside because it's what you feel on the inside. Romance is that feeling that, you know, the thought of that person when makes you smile and brings a smile to your face. Overall, romance is an awesome, amazing feeling, and I'm going to dig a little bit more deep inside and do some reminiscing, Dr. Pops, on some situations that I felt like romance was present. And we're gonna have to chit chat about this one some more, but you had me thinking, seriously, you really did. So thank you, Dr. Pops, for your question. I really appreciate it. Moving right along, we have Akala Vita. Her question was, what are your tips from experience to keeping / achieving personal happiness? And Calavita, for me right now, keeping that personal happiness, for one, I pray every morning. Before I do anything, I pray. Another thing is speaking positive words into my spirit on a daily. Affirmations has definitely become a part of my daily. Also, removing some toxic people out of my life and surrounding myself around some more positive people who are going to deposit that positivity into my bank, if you know what I mean. Another thing that brings about some personal happiness to me is being able to empower other women. Being able to share that through my videos here on YouTube, and it allows me to share my, you know, on Facebook and as well as Twitter. Traces of my lip gloss, being able to empower through that brings about some personal happiness. You know, being a mother brings about some personal happiness, even though there are some good days and some bad days, but being a mother and having my kids a part of my life definitely brings about some personal happiness, because I'm going to tell y'all the truth. I don't know where my life would be. I don't know where I would be right now today if my kids weren't a part of my life. And also, I didn't mention my gratitude journal. I am almost at 30 days. If you guys have not seen my video on gratitude journal, I encourage you to go back and take a look at it. And since I've been doing that, it has really helped my personal happiness, being able to reflect on the things on a daily that have brought about some good moments, you know, on a daily has been. Alright, something had happened with my phone. For many of you guys, you know that I record from my phone, but the video just stopped. And it said I didn't have any storage, so I had to go, you know, go back onto my phone and delete a few things to be able to complete this video. I left off with Calavita and finishing up her question, which was, what are your tips from experience to keeping achieving personal happiness? And let me just also add that exercising has brought about some personal happiness, even though I need to get back with it. I've been real lazy with it lately, but exercising, also cooking. I enjoy cooking and coming up with different recipes, trying new things. Those are just some things that bring about some personal happiness for me. And so Calavita is also a young lady who has been very, very supportive on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. She can definitely relate to me when it comes to women empowerment, because it's something that she is also involved in as well. And she has a blog, and I will be sure to share her blog in the description box. And I encourage you all to go and take a look. Check out her blog. So yeah, the last question, which is actually two questions that was asked, but it's from a Facebook friend, and also she's my cousin. But her name is Vanessa Dunn Guyton. If you're watching, ma'am, thank you so much again for asking your question and participating in my Q&A. And Vanessa's question was, her first question was, what motivates you to keep motivating others? I would have to say that knowing that there's others out there who need uplifting and encouragement and motivation just like I do, you know, we all need that, and we all should be able to have someone in our lives, whether we know them personally or not. We should be able to have someone in our lives that we can kind of rely on to give us that extra push or that extra encouragement, that extra uplifting that we may need on a daily. I feel like it's my job and my duty to be that person. What motivates me is knowing that there are other women out there who can relate to the things that I've been through and the things that I am going through. And I feel like as women, we need to be more supportive to one another and be able to be that helping hand that can, you know, if it's something that I've been through, I want to be able to feel comfortable enough to share that with someone else, that maybe they won't go through that same situation that I went through, or maybe they may be able to go through that same situation in a better way, you know, or in a different way. What motivates me is when I wake up in the morning, it's a feeling that I feel on the inside that makes me want to continue to motivate others. It's an indescribable feeling. I've tried to describe it on so many different occasions, but it's indescribable, and it's like only I really know what that feeling feels like. What also keeps me motivated is when I get that positive response back from people who watch videos, who read tweets, who see postings on Facebook, and I do get those positive comments back, and they say, you know what, I needed that, thank you for sharing that. Those are things as well that keeps me motivated. Her second part of her question was, how do you remain positive when you are not where you want to be in life? That's also a good question, because I'm definitely not where I want to be in life. I'm definitely not. But one thing that keeps me remaining positive is my faith, and knowing that where I am today is not home for me. You feel me? It's not where I'm going to be 5 years from now. It may not even be where I'm going to be 2 years from now. It's that faith of knowing that anything is possible, even though I may not see it, see what my outcome is going to be. But it's that faith, and my faith is growing daily. Faith is definitely one of those tricky things that can be tested on a daily. But it's that faith. It's that faith that allows me to feel like, you know what? Yeah, my life may not be where it is, where I want it to be right now at this present moment. But if I continue to do the things that I'm doing, if I continue to keep God present in my life and continue to build a relationship with God and continue to work towards positive change, there's no telling where my life might be. You know what I'm saying? So it's just that knowing in my mind, it's that faith, knowing in my heart that where I am now is not home. But to me, it's not. So that would just be the one thing that keeps me positive right now. So, yeah. I want to, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video, guys, but I want to thank Dr. Pops, Calavita, and Vanessa for participating in my first Q&A here on my channel. And I would really like to do future Q&As, you know, real soon. So if you guys thought of any questions while watching, I encourage you to go ahead and comment below. Let me know if you have a question and, you know, I can ask it on my next Q&A video. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this video up, but I want to thank you guys for watching, and until the next video, you all, love and beauty.